to be found. That is North and Siyoung.
Yes, Siyoung performed admirably in the last game. But again, this is pick and ban for game number two between OMG and Xiaogu. First one going to Xiaogu, this time their purple side. Sixth ban about to come across. Two of Swift's champions getting targeted in TNT's Vayne.
Yeah, no surprise. I think it's going to be a first priority, either Victor or Sivir. I think it has to be Victor. You cannot afford Doinbi to get his hands on that champion. Likewise, because Azir was also banned. So that's pretty much the big first-tier control mage, unless you're looking for Cassiopeia.
Yeah, OMG currently looking at Kool's Victor for that first pick. Some other big changes like Ryze and Kalista, of course, already removed. And just to clarify, this is patch 5.14. Elise, exceptionally strong. Gangplank, enabled.
Is it?
I believe it is.
I'd heard, but I hadn't double-checked. And I would have assumed that we would have. We'll find out.
We certainly shall. But again, Braum was hovered briefly. Siyoung looking at Maokai. Oh my goodness.
It's 5.13.
Oh, it is 5.13.
The only reason I say that is because leveling is a legacy Elise player.
Oh.
And so if we were on the 5.14 where Elise is big and buff, they would have for sure.
Yeah.
That's the thing. 5.14 is going to be really scary for LPL just because there's so many Elise players.
Yeah.
But it's not Victor. It is going to be Gragas. So again, this is 5.13. The Elise buffs, the Gangplank have not gone through yet for China. And it is going to be a Gragas first rotation, which, hey, that Victor.
Yeah, leave it right back open for Doinbi. He did exceptionally well in his previous set. You can see Siyoung communicating with his coach behind him. He's like, you asked for Gragas? Yeah, we got Gragas. We got it locked in. Currently V on your screen as he prepares for game number two. Braum once again locked in for TCT as Xiaogu. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Yep, there's no reason to pick up your jungler right now just because you already know that Gragas is going to be the jungler that you're facing across. So we'll see if Swift decides to commit on that Lee Sin. The last time he did, he actually got burned because he was facing RNG into a Rek'Sai. But no surprise there to see Doinbi pick up Victor. It is his number one played champion for the LPL Summer Split.
Yeah, lots of disengage coming up from OMG. They are prepared and ready. It seems like their team comp is all about that Kog'Maw. That's locked in.
This is, which again, this is North. You would say, okay, this makes perfect sense because their AD carry is not Uzi, it's North. I love Janna and Gragas. I talk about this all the time. You have the two biggest disengage ultimates available to your hyper scaling, low mobility AD carry like Kog'Maw. You've got the Monsoon and the Cask. Likewise, again, Kog'Maw going to get the initial power spike off that Trinity Force, and then with the level 9 Janna shield, it makes up for the fact that he didn't build flat AD, and then he's going to hyper scale into late game. I just love Kog'Maw. I think he's in a perfect spot for the current meta. I wish we would see more of him, and it's really starting to start to trend now, especially as we come closer to that 4.14.
TNT now left to respond to that. Currently looking at Jinx, was hovering Tristana as well. His Vayne already banned away, so continuing to stick with the hyper carry, something TNT very effective at. Maokai now locked in for V, and it looks like that's going to be Jinx locked in for TNT.
Wow, okay, so Sivir was available, and Xiaogu don't pull the trigger on it. So I think a little bit worried about not bringing a lot of damage to keep up with Kog'Maw. And, you know, subbing out instead for that Jinx who will hyperscale alongside him. Jinx probably one of the best Infinity Edge users in the game just because she can get the crit on her AoE.
Yeah. So huge. We'll see how that works out as OMG. Looking at their last two picks, that's going to be for the mid and top lane. Siyoung looking at Gnar. Let's see if he decides to commit to it.
We're bouncing right now between the Shen hover and the Gnar hover. So Gnar will have a little bit better of a 1v1 matchup against Maokai. That said, Maokai is not really going to care either way. Your Shim will obviously grant you more protection for your Kog'Maw and protect the AD carry comp. And then by bringing along Twisted Fate, you have double semi-global, as well as a lot of pick potential there. So I kind of prefer the Shen, but I understand you're still getting the same thing from the Gnar.
Yeah, it looks like Twisted Fate and Gnar are going to be locked in for OMG. Siyoung returning to the top laner that led to his win in his previous game against Xiaogu early on in the LPL.
Yep, did play Gnar alongside the Orianna. Unfortunately, Orianna didn't connect last game, so see if the Twisted Fate pulls off better. Again, it is also a cool special. And the thing that I like to talk about cool is there's so much talent right now in the LPL mid laners specifically. I mean, you've got Pawn, Rookie, Godby, you, Doinbi, Cool. it's hard to sit down. Dade, let's not forget that guy. It's hard to sit down and just rank them, and I feel like they all have their different specialties, as the last pickup will actually be Swift's jungle returning to that Sejuani.
Yeah.
Cool is kind of like the jack of all trades. He's good at everything. He's got a big champion pool. It's not as unique as, you know, Godfrey or Pawns, but he doesn't necessarily specialize in one area, but he's strong in all of them. Doinbee on the other side, we like to call him the genius mid laner, because he's just so smart in how he postures in his lane. And likewise, his secondary support ability to follow around Swift, he actually has the highest kill participation of any mid laner in the LPL, and he's the highest kill participation on anyone in his team, which Doinbee, you know, in the recent weeks has been ramping up and becoming kind of a staple power player for the LPL, but he didn't start out like that. He was the Lulu Morgana main, you know, kind of sitting in Swift's shadow, and it's only until recently that people look at Xiaogu and they go, oh, you know, Swift is incredible, TNT is a great econ AD carry, but Doinbee, that guy is a great mid laner.
Yeah, so once again, in the previous game, we got to see him follow Swift around on Nidalee. This time, he's got a Sejuani to help lock it down. The Arctic Assault on top of a Gravity Field, on top of a Chaos Storm just speaks.
On top of AoE Rockets of critting.
Yeah, it is going to be huge team fights coming out of Xiaogu, but those are our final rosters locked in for these two teams. It's do or die time for OMG. 7 points up for grabs. They need them.
And we talked about how OMG, you know, their identity changes as a team when they have North versus Uzi. When Uzi's on the team, it's all about him. They are playing North, but it's still an AD carry centric composition with that Kog'Maw providing him the disengage. You know, when Kool and Loveling are together, you would think that it would be all about the mid lane jungle synergy, but that's not the case here. So kind of scratching my head a bit, you know, if you're going to play a Kog'Maw and you're going to put all of your eggs in one basket, why wouldn't you play Uzi?
Not entirely certain, but we're getting ready. And we're actually loading into the Rift right now. We're getting into game number two. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the LPL. It's week 11, day number one, set number one, game number two. That's right. It's OMG versus Xiaogu.
And we finally have come to an end on LPL, the last week before playoffs.
Yep.
Every game counts here. Counts a little bit more for Xiaogu because this is the only set that they will play all weekend. They had a fantastic start to it, so we'll see if they can stay hungry and look for a great closeout to their LPL season.
TNT. Whoa, he's waiting in that bush for a long time.
It is so dangerous to sit there.
Wow.
Just because you can't see around the corner fog of war until they're right on top of you, which is why typically when you stand at that bush, you ward down into the pixel brush in River.
Mm. But TNT takes it patient. Looks like we might see a lane swap out of Xiaogu as recall being completed by TCT and TNT already heading to the top side. OMG went for a few deep wards. They managed to spot out the Gromp camp, but North and Amazing sitting pretty comfortable on the bottom side of the map, though. Doinbee? Oh, don't do it, Doinbee! Don't do it, Doinbee! No! He walks into the bush, face checks at level one, down to half health. There's nothing to keep alive. Flash heal cleanse keeps him alive. Doinbee survives.
But he burns both summoners. He is in the mid lane, so expect to see how Loveling will make use of that and gank again. So much gank pressure with the gold card, followed up by the chain CC of the belly bop.
Yeah.
That said, Doinbee, the genius mid laner. His posturing in lane is always very strong. He's used to playing Kassadin a lot, who is very fragile early level, so if someone's not going to have, or if someone is going to take a handicap, like losing both summoners,
it would be Doinbee. Just giving that handicap back over to OMG. Xiong actually gets to start off with the Gromp camp, while Amazing with the lane slot just looks to be a bully.
There's nothing you can do to Braum. And it's really scary, too, because they don't know where Swift is. So because the lane swap has been initiated by Xiaogu, Xiaogu have the numbers advantage on the top side of the map, which is why you immediately see Loveling and Xiong just say,
no, they look for the invade.
I don't want it.
Yeah, OMG not having a good time in their own jungle.
Oh, here comes Amazing, though. They're going to fight for this. This is a 3v3.
Yeah, let's see if they will be able to pull it off. Blue down to about 300 now, 5. That level 2 smite.
Oh,
the flash knockup finds Swift. He's forced to flash out of it. Double stun finds TCT and V.
Here comes Cool. He's got the yellow card ready. There's Flash. He's going to target V. He flashes as well. Zap comes out. It's 4 versus 4. Complete chaos in this early game.
Doinb
5 versus 4. No summoner spells. He gets back in. Amazing Scott. He's got no Flash. Are they going to get first blood? They do. It's on TNT.
Oh, worst case scenario. You did not want that to go over to the Jinx. Her snowball potential is incredible. And Xiaogu, with the numbers advantage because they have the lane swap, collapse 5 members on the blue buff, take the first blood, deny leveling's jungle, and move into the game.
Yeah, absolute chaos in this early game, but Xiaogu start off with a healthy dose of momentum. Doinbi, no summoner spells, still able to be effective. Now Cool, no summoner spells either, but oh no. They're looking for Cool right now. Here comes TCT. He's got the yellow card prepped up. He's running as quick as he can. TCT just needs to land the Winter's Blight. Oh, can't quite find it.
You have to expect this, though. There's no way that they're going to look for a dive. So it's either they reset their positioning and they go back to their lanes, as well as jungle, or they look for the gank on the mid lane. So good posturing from Cool to play to the bottom side of the map and suspect that the 4-man roaming gank squad could be coming.
Yeah, very solid play out of Cool to get out with his life, but 4 minutes in, lane swap initiated. Yeah, TCT.
Get out of here.
He's just being a nuisance.
Braum level 1. This is why, you know, we've seen the resurgence of Braum, is the immediate buffs to his Q, but more importantly, you know, lane swaps are still very prevalent in the LPL meta. If you're able to unlock your support like Braum, your level 1 power and your roam potential early levels is so potent with the Q and concussive blows.
Yeah, V's double jungling with Swift right now. He's actually missing out on a lot of experience as he's helping Swift through. North getting some solo farm on the bottom side. He's got a CS lead over TNT 4 now, but he's going to have to keep pace with that first blood advantage on TNT.
Yeah, and that's the thing that I was really just about to point out is about, so the 10 CS discrepancy, it pretty much equals up that first blood. I think TNT might still be slightly ahead, but it's negligible. I wish I could speak English.
Anemone, right?
Anemone. Aluminum. Oh, there's no Australians here.
Yeah.
Aluminium. The producer of this game is a dirty look.
Yeah, you can see that gold on the bottom side. About 250 in TNT's pocket ahead of North. So we'll keep an eye on whether or not that Jinx can continue to hyperscale. Xiong, level 4. Not having a terrible time CSing, but TNT setting up the freeze is going to make it more difficult. While V continues to follow Swift around, they're completely sacrificing Maokai's experience.
Yeah, level 4 to level 2 is a massive difference. And this could have been, you know, why OMG decided to pull the trigger on Gnar versus Shin. Gnar acts very much like an AD carry will in a 2v1 scenario, and obviously because he's ranged with the reach of his boomerang, it's much easier and much safer for him to actually be in the 2v1 versus the double jungle.
Oop, OMG looking for the invade right now. Blue still hasn't been taken by Xiaogu, and are they going to give it over to Cool? Not entirely certain. Yeah, Cool does secure that first blue buff, and OMG get out scot-free.
So we'll see how he's able to impact the map with this, or at least bully out his lane. Doinbi will not have the blue available to him. Actually hasn't even done his back, whereas Cool has gotten double Dorns as well as boots.
Yep.
And is about to hit level 6.
Very scary spike for that Twisted Fate as North finds a minion wave shoved to the turret. Two members of Xiaogu are set to defend it. Razor Sharp means Loveling can look for the invade, but Spotsle will secure it on the move.
This is actually going to be really scary if Xiaogu can't get the experience onto this Maokai.
Swift takes a hit. Minion wave is rushing in. Lovely.
Here comes Braum.
Yeah, he can't decide if he wants to pull the trigger. Swift does it for him. Here comes the Destiny. Twisted Fate trying to get under there. Amazing tanks it perfectly. Oh, but you're right. Here comes Braum indeed. V dodges the red card. There goes the Unbreakable as well. Four members of OMG.
Now Doinbi.
Yeah, he does. He does have level 6, actually. But they're out. You're right.
Okay, so that was a fantastic dive. Amazing learned his mistakes from their previous blunder in the first game. This time, tanks it perfectly, even did his little stop key just on the outside of tower range, shielding himself up. So fantastic dive from OMG. This is what we come to expect. Their communication looking much better this time around than that first game. The thing that I'm concerned about is still this level disparity between Xiong and V. So V right now sitting at level 4, Xiong's very close to level 6. More importantly, his teleport is just about to come up. That's a teleport, so Gnar will have impact on the bottom side of the map with ult available.
Yeah, looks like we're actually seeing a lane swap out of OMG 8 minutes in. They're going to keep Cool on the bottom side against V and TCT, whereas North is amazing.
look to be farming it up in the mid lane.
This is an interesting adaptation. That's the word I'm going to use.
Okay.
So obviously Cole burning his Destiny down there. It could just be that he doesn't have a good back timing window for him. You know, we talked about the initial early back of taking the double Doran's into the boots. And so, you know, while I'm here, I just don't want to walk back up to mid lane, so let me farm this out. You have to go back anyway and itemize,
yeah.
Rush towards mid. Yeah, there we go. Now the swap's coming back. So they just did that because Cole didn't have anything to buy. Gets the CDR boots. This is fairly common for Twisted Fate. Really empowering the Destiny. And again, the fact that Xiong has the teleport as well as the level advantage having his ult while V does not is massive. I expect OMG that if they really want to abuse their lead to work on this teleport ult advantage.
We'll have to see if they do succeed. Amazing once again on the deep invade with an early sight stone. Actually, no, that's just good old-fashioned wards. Keeps vision up. Doesn't want to let Swift be as big a nuisance as the previous game.
There are a lot of things going on. Doinby's like, danger. Danger.
Danger, Will Robinson. Danger.
That's, I was going to say it's Robinson. It's something.
Robinson Crusoe. Wait, no. That's
no, hello? Please respond.
Yeah, lost in space. Looks like Xiong lost in his own jungle. Gets a nice safe ward before he heads back into lane. Recall looks to build a Hex Drinker. Even though he's leaning against a Jinx early on, he's expecting eventually to have to deal with it, while North might be able to take the first turn of the game in the bottom.
This is still... Oh, Rocket? They're looking to engage on this. That's the only reason why he would send that Rocket down there, is to either alleviate pressure on the AoE splash on the creep wave so that North just can't sit there and siege. But I think that Xiaogu were trying to possibly communicate and engage there because Swift is also on that side of the map. That said, again, Sejuani, Maokai do not have their ultimates available. Xiong, level 7. OMG, you are at a massive advantage right now with your teleport and your Gnar. Use it.
Seems like they can't quite pull the trigger.
They don't have anything
yet
to pull the trigger on.
Yeah, they're waiting, but uh-oh. Seems like we might see some action now. Doinby very far forward in this lane. Loveland not going to pull the trigger once again. He sees Swift clearing out a ward, and the vision this time around from OMG has been on par. I mean, these guys have got wards all over the jungle of Xiaogu.
Well, it's very easy to do that because you are against a Sejuani who's really not going to have her power until she's post level 6. So Loveland just doing a great job recognizing that he has the ability to bully Swift early.
TCT swaps back down to the bottom lane. TCT to help him out. Picks up an Avarice Blade and a BF Sword for his troubles.
So not planning on fighting anytime soon. Does have a decent power spike, kind of the flat AD, whereas Kog'Maw only has Phage available to him. Curious, I mean, again, Xiaogu, they're effectively waiting for their ults, but they have them now. You know, Swift level 6 now. V also finally level 6.
Yeah, leveling again. Just continuing to invade. He's actually going the long way around.
He's gonna be spotted.
He will be spotted out. Immediately they see him. Oh, he's got a timer on the roof.
Which is also going to signal Swift to collapse onto this. So both teams know this can be a 5v5 if the top laners pull the trigger on teleport.
Yeah, they're diving onto the tier 1 right now. It's complete chaos. His TNT is the target. He doesn't have his flash. Already used his heal. Teleport coming out as well. North secures the kill. The turret goes down, but V completes his teleport in time. Four members. But they decide not to dive any further. Tier 1 secured, and they shut down TNT.
The teleport goes through, but too little too late. There's nothing that Xiaogu can do, but he's looking for the ult.
Ooh, he misses just barely. Finds the slow on the north, but he's got no follow-up. There's no damage down there. Finally, Doinby catches up, but it's too late.
And this is what I was trying to iterate, is the fact that even if he hit that ultimate, Doinby was there as your primary source of damage. The AD carry wasn't, but he had no mana. That's maybe a laser and a possible Chaos Storm. Xiaogu just wasted all of their big cooldowns, lost their advantage on the bottom side of the map, lose it on the top side, and will now surely lose Dragon.
Yeah, this is Blue going over to Doinby, but that top tier 1 is almost certainly going to be taken as... Yeah, it is indeed. 2 turrets to 0, OMG, and completely shoring up that early game trouble that they had.
Xiaogu do have a window here where they can look for this dragon because OMG are trying to stagger their backs and just spend their massive amount of global gold they just got off of the two towers. So this is why North is cautious, why he can't leave, because if he does, Xiaogu are going to immediately pull onto that dragon.
It's tagged by a winner's bite. Unbreakable soaks some more damage. Loveling actually heads back down to the bottom lane to look for a little bit more pressure. don't have Vision of Swift right now, but they're chasing forward. Chompers is going to find Amazing. Knockup finds TNT.
Is he going to get the kill?
He can't quite find it. Body block. No. Oh, the shield baits him out. He goes low. TCT gets caught. North, another kill. 3-0-1.
Beautiful body block from North right there to deny the reset. So the reason why Jinx was stepping forward is because he needed to get excited proc off of Amazing. The body block on the zap saved that fight.
Yeah, OMG playing very solid this game. Nearly 4,000 gold ahead in this set. 13 minutes into the game. And it seems like everything Xiaogu are trying just is not succeeding.
That said, Xiaogu are weak at this point in the game. We talked about, you know, Swift and V, they were set behind with kind of the initial invade shenanigans, pulling all of their resources to collapse onto that blue. Xiong just kind of spiraling ahead. Hello?
Yeah, double flash burns the Chaos Storm.
He'd have to hit the Q there as well.
Yeah.
I guess he gets the flash out of the Twisted Fate, but...
That's just going to force the recall. TCT clears a ward, and the rest of OMG managed to clear another one. They know he's in that bush because they've got a ward on the far side. Now they see him once again. Dragon still not taking this game. 14 minutes in, and very low Dragon priority from both of these teams.
Well, the team with the Kog'Maw seems to be getting the Dragon first, and that's why it's such a delayed Dragon, because again, you're waiting for Kog'Maw's Trinity Force to come out. So OMG still have all of the cards in terms of if it comes to a straight 5v5 with this Dragon. That said, they could still, you know, posture incorrectly, do a miss back, and allow Xiaogu a window of opportunity to sneak in there. But so far, I mean, OMG just... really need to collapse on it. Need to be a bit careful, though, because you are still facing a wombo combo comp. The AoE damage and Venn diagram murder control of Victor Sejuani.
Very scary team composition from Xiaogu. We'll see if they decide to go back to their earlier styles of wait 45 minutes into the game and then look for one exceptional 5v5. OMG. Looking like they don't want that to happen. They've got a bit more control with that mid-game Twisted Fate.
They are committing their resources top lane, so again, this should, although Loveling's on blue buff, he's across map, handing this over to Kool, so just an unfortunate timing.
Yeah, Teleport's about to be back up for V. Xiong's already got his blue buff, is secured by Kool, while TNT is going to get some much needed time to free farm. Immediate ping onto Dragon from North and Amazing.
They know that they can find it. So again, prioritizing the fact that we need to snowball Jinx up, we need to get her to a 3-item power spike, the BF upgrade, typically Infinity Edge, the Zeal upgrade, typically Static Shiv on Jinx, and the Armor Penetration, the Last Whisper, before they can really look towards these 5v5. So again, prioritizing farm and safety for your AD carry as a trade for the Dragon.
OMG can do anything outside of this as Dragon is secured. North locks it down, and a lot of deep vision into Swift's red side jungle.
Means
he can see
dive.
Exactly where he is, and oh man, OMG just
him.
Might be, yeah.
Pop him off the tower. Swift is there for the counter, though.
See if they do pull the trigger. Gravity Field finds Kool with Kool at low health. I don't know that they can commit to
it. Which is a good coverage by Swift, understanding what was happening. You know, again, the communication from Xiaogu tracking OMG's members across the map that say, hey, I'm probably going to get casked off this tower. Can you just stand behind me with your ultimate? Thanks, mate.
Yeah. Now, that does mean TNT finds some alone time with the top tier one of Xiong. He's able to drop it and trade for the first turret of Xiaogu. So North and Loveling look to trade on the other side of the map for another tier two.
And this is effectively a complete 180 of what we saw happen last game. So OMG this time with the Kog'Maw looking to siege up on the Trinity Force power. They want to take as many turrets as possible before this Jinx can get rolling.
Rocket is going to just barely tickle North as it comes across the map. Unfortunately, you're not Ezreal, so not quite able to clear minions as effectively as you would hope. Pressure from OMG across two lanes means that Xiaogu are forced to be defensive for now, and you know, I think they're okay with that.
No, you're absolutely right. Xiaogu at this point, they're just trying to control the bleeding, stall the game out, wait for their AD carry, and OMG, they recognize we're strong now, we need to siege, snowball off of objectives, and that's why you see the itemization of the Lich Bane coming out of Twisted Fate. It's prioritizing tower sieging versus 5v5.
See if OMG can try taking more turrets. Xiong looks like he might get some time onto the top tier one. Oh, minions, the minions.
Just need one more auto.
Oh, come on. Oh, man, turret doesn't fall, but it's about to. any second now that thing's going to go down. While Xiong pulls V back to the top side of the map to continue defending his own tier 2. He's now nearly 40 CS ahead. Though he does find a Swift in his face, tries to bounce away. Oh, doesn't pull the trigger on the Absolute Zero. Destiny is used. They're ganking TCT on the far side of the map. V looks to teleport north, trying to catch up. Knockup finds Loveling. TNT gets out with his life.
So again, what they were trying to do is pull multiple resources with the lead that Xiong has amassed in levels and CS, and then quickly rotate to the bottom side of the map to get a numbers discrepancy to push down that tower. Good response teleport from both teams to save it and kind of stall OMG out of it.
Yeah, no teleport for either of those top laners now, and uh-oh. Looks like TCT might face check a brush with a Kog'Maw into it, but they're just looking to clear away the Gromp from the far side. Finally, the mid-tier one goes down to the consistent pressure of OMG. And OMG, that really seems to be the theme with this game. If in the first game they didn't put out too much pressure, this time it's a complete 180. Like you said, they are all over the map.
Yeah, and it was just kind of a blunder from Xiaogu's early game, you know, initiating the lane swap, trying to take control of those towers through Jinx's pushing power. But again, the team with the Kog'Maw able to slow down the early game late enough that Kog'Maw finds his Trinity Force. And this is what I was talking about, you know, forcing the flash, right?
Yeah.
Kog'Maw and Vayne, they get a mid-game power spike off of Trinity and Blade of the Rune King. And then they continue to hyperscale.
Doinby's caught out. Looks like he's forced to burn his cleanse as Loveling actually cast to knock him into the fight. He's doing enough damage, but the flash stun finds Doinby. They're trying to keep him alive, but he goes down to the knockup from Loveling. Doesn't have time to escape from this one. Another stun finds Swift, but he's so tanky, especially in the damage reduction field of Maokai.
But this is brilliant to continue to skirmish Xiaogu. You do not want to face them 5v5. Here comes the rocket.
Ooh, let's see if he will secure the red.
One day.
Oh, did he get it? He got it. Oh my gosh, he secured the red buff.
Golf clap, please.
Yeah, not quite the wild turtle secure the dragon, but still a pretty solid play.
Really?
You got to take it back.
Really?
Of all of the cross-map Jinx ultimates that you've seen, what has been the most influential?
How about Name stealing the Baron?
Oh, yeah.
But it's cool. We'll go turtle. Yeah. Same thing, right?
How about that? Well, V is going to catch some CS on the far side, still two levels down behind Xiong. And OMG continuing to look for skirmishes, continuing to look for picks. They did find a kill onto Doinby, but weren't able to turn it into another turret.
I wonder if the microphone would pick it up if I just slapped you.
Don't mind me while I step over here.
Okay, so we've got this dragon spawning in 1 minute 15, like you said. OMG, in full control of the game right now, they are sitting on a pretty hefty gold lead. But again, it just comes back to the fact that OMG understand that they can't really 5v5. It's still relatively dangerous to 5v5 Xiaogu just because of how their composition works. The wombo combo of the Sejuani ultimate on top of Victor AoE, on top of Jinx AoE. Mm-hmm. So it's very dependent that they continue to find these picks, specifically with Twisted Fate.
Yeah, you can see the gold on the bottom half of the screen right now. Speaking of that Twisted Fate, cool. A solid 1,700 gold ahead of Doinby. He's even going to zone Swift out of his own jungle right now. And poor guy, he's down a bit of gold himself. A solid 1,100 behind Loveling. Even V is down 1,500 gold behind Xiong.
And it just comes back to that there are level discrepancies across every single lane except for the jungle right now for Xiaogu.
Yeah, things not looking very solid in this set. 5-1. Xiaogu waiting for that late game team fight. That clock cannot tick any slower, but OMG will find a siege onto this tier 2. They're going to try breaking it down. Lichbane, Sheen procs shred through its health.
And there are three massive pressure points on the map right now that OMG have created. Mid lane, top lane, and now the bottom lane, which means that this should be a free dragon should they collapse back onto it, especially because Swift is appearing on all of this vision on the top side.
Yeah, Infinity Edge finally finished for TNT.
That's good.
He's grouped up with the rest of his team in the mid lane, though V a bit separate. Looks like they might want to try contesting this as they are grouped up, but OMG are ready.
Yeah, they're already on it. They'd be checking each blind. The problem is that they don't have any vision of the dragon being taken, and so if they walk over there into a gold card, it would mean disaster. The game would snowball possibly into a Baron from that point. So Xiaogu again, just kind of sitting back. You know, it's second dragon. We can let this one go. Stop the bleeding. Wait for TNT.
Yeah, you just saw the vision scrolled through on the minimap right there. No sight stone from Swift. means that he's not putting out anywhere near as much vision as he usually does. Actually rushes the Locket of the Iron Solari with this recall. And you can see the disparity. OMG have got complete and total vision of Xiaogu's jungle, of even the river. Poor Xiaogu, they're barely able to farm. They can't even take their own jungle king.
That said, Xiaogu are very comfortable playing from behind, actually. It happens quite a bit in a lot of their games, and it's like you keep alluding to. You know, Xiaogu, they used to be this team you wait for that big 40-minute, one-game-changing team fight. And even from a discrepancy, Xiaogu are incredible at team fighting, which, again, is why you keep seeing OMG respect it. And instead of looking for the 5v5, continue to attempt to skirmish and pick.
It seems like we might find another one. Cool split pushing in the bottom lane while the rest of OMG group up in the mid. The next tier two appears to be the target as that top lane resets and a minion wave crashes into the bottom inhibitor turret. TNT's already set to catch it. He's getting some much needed gold income while the rest of his team runs distraction. It's all about TNT. Can he get to that three item break?
Should be relatively close to upgrading his static shiv at this point. He actually probably has it available, but just can't stagger out this back. We do have a bit of Baron play, so again, because the dragon is down, it's a 6-minute window of opportunity where both teams can play to the top side of the map, because by being up there and using your resources up on that side, you're not sacrificing your dragon control. And again, this game, if OMG get a sizable pick, or pretty much either way, if either team get a sizable pick, it can quickly snowball into a dragon, which is why you see Xiaogu being so cautious. You know, let's not approach that dragon, because there's no reason to risk it, because if we do lose there, like risk versus reward, if we do lose there, we'll possibly lose the game. Stall it out, wait for another chance.
OMG continuing to assert pressure onto Xiaogu, this time in the top lane. Just continuing to run Xiaogu across the map. Doinb doing his best to clear minion waves, but every time the wave is about to crash into the turret, who's there to catch it but TNT? This time Doinb, he says, you got mid lane, I get top lane.
And OMG have kind of run out of room to run in terms of their split push composition. They do still have two outer towers in the top and the mid lane, but it's not like you can hold on.
Find Swift here.
Teleport.
Drop teleport as Xiaogu are all grouped up. They could look to turn this, but
it's Meganaw. They have to wait for the cooldown.
Yeah, Xiong looks to go in. Oh, in the jungle. Cask separates the team. Doinb taking so much damage. He drops the Chaos Storm. Heal keeps him alive. The laser. They're looking for the execute, but they don't find the reset. They finally do on the far side. Xiong and North tries to split it off. North is almost tagged. He needs to be hit one more time. The stun finds him. Swift chases over the wall. Doinb secures the kill. That's two members dead of OMG. And Xiaogu are continuing to chase. Now they find Xiong. Hexdrinker's not going to keep you alive from a scary Jinx. Double kill on the Doinb, and Xiaogu take the team fight.
Right back in it, and this is what we were talking about. OMG were so respectful not to look for a 5v5, and that is why. From the discrepancy, Xiaogu outfight, split the fight, now looking at the Baron.
Yeah, they certainly are. Vision being cleared out. There's another ward in the back of the pit, but Xiaogu don't even care. They're going to shred through this Baron's health. Destiny Gate looks to bring Cool back up with Amazing. Tornado charging up. Can he get it? No, the Unbreakable trying to stop anything from getting in there. Xiaogu look to secure it. They succeed. Baron is taken. They're going to land the zap. But OMG look to just be a nuisance.
There is still this. Oh, are they fighting?
He's got no mana.
They're trying to stall for leveling.
Oh no, this is a scary position. Doinb, he's caught in the pit. He goes down Cool with the execution.
One Baron down. Leveling is still on the chase.
Yeah, he certainly is. Xiong teleporting from the far side. TCT tries to recall. He gets knocked back by the cast. Jump to the minion front. You can do it. Oh, TCT buys some time for his team. He dies so his allies may live.
And what's super important is North is in the mid lane setting up a pressure point. So OMG could look to transition this into a tower.
Yeah, V dashing to the top side to catch that minion wave. Swift splits to the mid. Send both tanks to both lanes. Five members of OMG are up. Swift doesn't make it in time. North takes the tier two. The minions, oh no, don't in fact finish it off, but it might as well. North takes a rocket to the face. Cleanse tries to keep him alive. Swift, oh, he ends up going down and North gets out alive.
The Blade of the Rune King coming in massive right there. And again, that is just a single auto attack from that mid-tier tower going down. So yes, Xiaogu, win the team fight, get the Baron, but it really is just a breather for them. It's not a transition of power. They're still waiting for TNT's last item, that last whisper.
He is trying to build towards it as quickly as he possibly can.
Is he building Blade of the Rune King?
He has a Vamp Scepter. Could just be for sustain. I mean, he's taking a lot of just extra damage.
No, it would make sense just because primary, the only armor that you're facing across right now is Xiong, and he has the what's going to be a Randuin's Omen. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, it's pretty much primarily MR, even with the Spectre's Cowl as well as the Hex Shrinker. And then if you look at Gragas, Gragas has the Lock of the Iron Solari, still hasn't itemized into any armor. So if you have the Blade of the Rune King, you're pretty much just protecting yourself for more kite potential, as well as Tank Shred. It's not awful. I would still prioritize the armor penetration, but we'll see where he goes with it.
We certainly shall. Blue buff is secured by Doinby. Dragon comes up in 15 seconds, and the mid-tier one finally drops to a minion shove. Xiaogu in the jungle once again.
And what's important here is Xiaogu now understand that they can fight for this dragon. This is going to be the 5v5. Itemization on Doinby, you have the Hex Core. He went for the very early Void Staff to be relevant for this mid-game team fight. Has the Morellos complete, so OMG, yeah, and they know, that's why they're backing off. So it's just about the respect of Meganar, which I believe actually just got popped.
Yeah, there goes the Destiny
Gate. Oh no,
it's
about to pop.
Yeah, Xion so close, he's trying to stall it out. Cool, joins up with the rest of his team. Dragon gets
Meganar
shredded down. It's secured by OMG.
Oh!
Meganar finds TNT. He's locked down, but then knocked out of the fight. Xiaogu are fighting without their AD carry. He's finally going to catch up. Doinby picks up a kill of his own, but Swift gets traded right back over. V right in the front line. Cool.
Blows the reset. His
he's got nothing to do. TNT takes a lot of extra damage, but he's still alive.
The reset.
He's fighting it around as best he can. North looks for TNT. Unbreakable down. TNT goes down. North secures another kill. Doinby running for his life. He's pinned against the wall. North secures the ace for OMG.
Disaster for Xiaogu. We talked about the Meganar. You had to respect it. And Xion gets a beautiful stun on TNT, completely denies him out of the majority of that fight. And then unfortunately TNT, he fumbles the minigun and the rocket form, and he's not able to get the resets needed. That was pretty much a triple kill waiting to happen. Oh, wow.
Yeah. Unfortunately, his little heart rates are broken right now as it's 13-6 in favor of OMG. They secure Dragon number 3, take an ace onto Xiaogu, and they might be looking for this last tier too.
But that's where Xiaogu were strong. They split their damage. They decided we're burning down the dragon as opposed to just looking for the hard engage. So by splitting their intentions, they lose the team fight. Xiong coming up huge again.
Very solid play from OMG in this set. They've got momentum in their favor. 9,000 gold ahead from Xiaogu. 7 points up for grabs. These guys want to make it into the top 4 for playoffs.
Going straight BT, completely bypassing any armor penetration. TNT is going for raw damage and survivability.
Yeah, and the Randuin's has just been finished, literally just picked up. So we'll see how he's going to be able to shred through this time, as now he has both of his summoner spells available. So if Xiong manages to get the Meganar once again.
Kog'Maw also, North, building a Last Whisper. You actually do more damage from Kog'Maw, as well as you get more penetration because of how his W works if you build an attack speed item like Phantom Dancer versus the Last Whisper third item on Kog'Maw. So that is a
interesting choice.
Pretty cost inefficient build in terms of your damage output.
Okay, well, we'll see how North manages to play it off, as it was just even CS between those two AD carries, but look at his KDA.
7-1-2.
It's pretty good.
Is that Uzi?
Yeah.
North actually has the highest KDA on OMG. He's sitting at 5. Likewise, that said, he doesn't have nearly the sample size of the rest of the OMG members are. But you know, when you're acting as the rotating sub for someone like Uzi,
yeah,
those are massive shoes to fill, and North has actually looked surprisingly good.
Certainly has. Helping him out quite a bit is leveling in the jungle. 5-1-6 on that Gragas. That's an 11 KDA.
You know, after his Demacia Cup, he had an interview, and North said, as they look for a team fight.
Oh,
separates.
Kask actually knocks V back in. He gets picked off.
Yeah, that was, you know, you wouldn't expect that to happen right there because V had flash available, but just mechanical misstep. Good CC chain from Loveling to find the bounce back, separate the Maokai, and shred through with Kog'Maw.
Yeah, OMG pressuring multiple lanes right now as Xiong split pushes in the bottom lane. The rest of OMG without that V tank look to take out an inhibitor turret. They're actually pressuring all three. Let's see if they can end up taking an inhibitor. Unbreakable for TCT, smoking some damage. Flash is used as Kool looks to dive on the TNT. He flashes once again, but stun under the turret. Rock Up is going to find some damage, but Swift has no follow-up for now. They're trying to pick off these kills while one inhibitor turret has fallen. Kool will die for this. It's picked up by TNT, but the inhibitor is under siege. Teleport from V. He's got home guard. There's the Chaos Storm. Doinby gets meleeed by a Kog'Maw. He's down to less than 100 health, but gets out alive again. Nord locked down. TNT drops him to zero health.
Massive pickup for TNT right there. I believe he just got two shut down. So, what, 1,000 gold intake for this Jinx. That said, they lose the inhibitor as well as the inhib tower on the bottom side. So OMG still coming out ahead in terms of map control.
Yeah, Xion kiting Swift around right now, and that's 8 turrets to 1 in favor of OMG. Remember, to win games, you don't need kills. You don't need team fights. Heck, you don't even need barons. You need to destroy the enemy's nexus. And with 8 buildings down compared to the 1 of Xiaogu, OMG got that in the bag. So Baron, being started.
Thanks, John Madden. Here comes OMG. Loveling's there.
They're right there.
He has a stronger smite.
Shred through. Let's see if he can drop Doinbee. Down to 3,000 health. There's TCT in the front line. Unbreakable goes down. And no, it's secured. They managed to secure the Baron, but Xiaogu are locked into that pit. There's no flash for TNT. He's stunned against the wall, taking so much damage. Doinbee goes low. TCT trying to trade it around, but OMG pick up kill after kill.
And again, the Baron offers no victory for Xiaogu, simply a breather. But with so many members dead, primarily their massive wave clear, OMG could theoretically just rush in here and end the game.
Yeah, they just might be able to. 30 seconds before those two primary carries are back up. Minion wave with a super minion. They're on Nexus turret number 1. Home guard from V and Swift are going to get them right back in while North and Xion look to clear out the last inhibitor turret. Looks like we're about to see all 3 inhibitors broken as V and Swift try to run distraction.
That's an interesting bug. Kog'Maw.
Yeah, he's constantly exploding. You might say he is with this game as the last inhibitor turret falls. Doinbee and TNT are back up, but OMG are just running Xiaogu around the map.
Bit of a mistake there not to just push North and Amazing past the tower and to attempt to break at least one of the Nexus turrets. That said, again, you have 2 opened inhibitors, 1 inhibitor down. Xiaogu are pretty much standing on their last leg. And OMG, complete 180 from their previous game. Communication looking a lot stronger.
Yeah, Rocket will find Loveling. V actually, oh, face checks into 4 members of OMG. Here's Swift, he tries to turn it around. He's taking a lot of damage. He gets out alive. Xion is caught. He's stunned, he goes down. They need to secure the dragon, but they're focusing on Kuhl instead. 2,700 health. Xiaogu find a fight. They get 2 picks. They stop the potential of that 4th dragon.
First dragon, 35 minutes, is massive. You have to think, that is scaling AP and AD on pretty much 4 completed items across the board. This is probably the largest power spike in terms of just raw stats that you could get in the game.
With OMG banging on the Nexus and inhibitors itself, Xiaogu find a fight. They take their dragon and secure the mid-tier 1 turret. Finally, their 2nd turret of the game. Can Xiaogu come back from this?
We've actually seen them do this multiple times. Again, Xiaogu, if you just stall out a game long enough where it comes down to 1 team fight, they are possibly the scariest team to be looking across to do that. I mean, you're up there with EDG, Snake, and Xiaogu.
Yeah.
50-minute game, 1 team fight, that's who I don't want on the enemy team.
Yeah, no problem. OMG now only ahead by about 7,000 gold as North.
I hate that.
Yeah, he is just going off. You could say he's exploding this game. 8-2-2 right now with enormous amounts of damage. He's a bomb ready to blow.
Are you just like trying to say, how many can I get in here?
Yeah, I know. I'm keep going.
Just load it up.
His timer is ticking. They need to cut the red wire.
I just want to give you a minute and see how many Kog'Maw. No, don't do
we'll
cameraman. Xiaogu marching up mid lane. We do have a bit of some split pressure shenanigans.
Yes.
That was hard to say. Split pusher. Oh, I give up.
You can't even a little bit. Xiaogu, they take down the mid-tier 2 turret. They look undaunted, however. Xion continues to split on the far side of the map, but Xiaogu are content.
Because right now, OMG's win condition is North. That exploding Kog'Maw right there that you hear on your screen. Protect him. They have the tools to do it in the Monsoon and the Cask, but look at the dive from Xiaogu. A Righteous Glory, he doesn't have it, but just a sped up Maokai into your backline. Swift ultimate, the reach of Doinbee. 5v5, even with this CS advantage.
Oh, the ultimate comes out. They try to tag Kuhl. TCT's actually in the front. Unbreakable soaks all of his team damage,
no.
But he flashes over the Cask and OMG.
They're just trying to stall time to take down that Nexus Tower.
They just might be able to. The minions are getting on. The Nexus turret is still going to be standing.
Three inhibs up.
Yeah, let's see. One inhibitor does go down. They're trying to get around from the side, but OMG, get in and get out.
Looking for possibly more. The wave clear of Jinx. Better players crit more.
Yeah. Cool splitting on the far side. He's got his Destiny Gate to get him away from anything. As he
shred through that.
Yeah, he's looking to split. V tries to catch up with him, zones him away successfully, but the rest of OMG are undaunted. They continue putting pressure in the bottom lane.
Applying pressure through all three lanes. We've got Loveling in the mid lane. Now again, Kask is just about to come up. That's going to be an incredibly important cooldown because OMG, it is all about either split push or Kog'Maw. And if either of these things don't work, they will fall to a 5v5 from Xiaogu.
See if Xiaogu can take the 5v5 they need, or if OMG can successfully put this pressure on. They start trying to tag the inhibitor, though. Xiang does get tagged by the winner's bite. He's going to continue trying to bully it through. North once again looking to get onto it, but TNT is slowly but surely giving up ground.
Cool is going to lose this 1v1, and OMG are going to lose a massive pressure point.
See if he does. Xiang so close to Meganar, but he's waiting it out, and Cool chunked down to half health.
And look at where this gold lead was for OMG, and look at where it is now. This is only 6k, which this late in the game, that effectively means nothing. They finally do get it.
Teleport from behind. He manages to catch Amazing Cleanse on the North. Xiang trying to peel Amazing Force to flash, and here comes V from behind. This
Cool's
is the
going
fight
for the
they're looking for. But Cool split pushing in the base. Xiang gets caught. They pick off two kills. Cool looking for the Nexus turret, but the rest of his team isn't there. Recall being enacted by V. He's trying to catch up. Loveling trying to peel, but Nexus turret goes down, and OMG continuing to split. Are they going to look for that last Nexus turret or the inhibitor? No. Okay.
Okay, so they sacrifice the fight, although Loveling, no, he's fine.
Yeah,
should
be chasing, but not able to find it. Baron's up in a minute. Dragon, 90 seconds.
OMG sacrifice the team fight. They take the objectives.
Yes.
Cool did a great job micromanaging his blue card as well as proccing his Lich Bane to shred through that Nexus tower. Xiaogu cannot leave their base. This should be a free Baron for OMG. They just need to be patient. If they get aced, 39 minutes, 40 minutes into the game, that's probably it because you have Kog'Maw on one side, you have Jinx on the other. No one is going to wreck turrets faster than those two champions.
Yeah, their playoff spots are on the wire right now. OMG looking for something better than fifth, whereas Xiaogu trying to secure that second place.
Top four means so much to these teams just because it pretty much guarantees you circuit points because it makes your playoff bracket that much easier. Xiaogu, it's incredibly important that they finish as high as possible in the LPL season and the LPL playoffs because they didn't get to participate in the spring circuit for circuit points. So if they need to get invited to that world's qualifiers, they need to show up big for summer.
Baron is up. V actually forced to recall and deal with the minions and
come
a
on,
split pushing
rocket
cool.
Baron steal.
Yeah, OMG looking for it. Let's see if TNT will fire the rocket.
He
no,
needs
he's
to fire it
for
now.
Cool instead. There goes the rocket, but Baron is already going to be secured. It crosses the map, finds Loveling half a second too late. That's Baron. Two inhibitors and one Nexus turret down. OMG, this could be the shove that wins this split. This game.
Has to come down to the fight. Here's the pick.
Yeah, Xiang in the front line. Elixir of Iron and Eye of the Storm keeps him so tanky. Cool continuing to split push from the far side. Xiaogu falling further and further back as they need to defend their Nexus.
I mean, that said, Xiaogu, they can't leave their base, but OMG have to come knocking on that door if they want to win. It depends. How patient are they going to be? Are they going to try to flood the base with Baron super creeps, which would probably be the safest option?
Seems like they're trying to play it patiently with this one. North just waiting for his chance to get onto the Nexus. TNT actually gets tagged by some damage, and finally he's going to find some damage onto the inhibitor, but that thing is continuing to regenerate.
The problem is that they're not applying Baron in every single lane, so it'll slowly build up as you see into the top side, but having to stay together because Xiaogu want to pull this trigger.
Yeah, that you can see V chasing forward step after step. Here come the Baron up minions north.
doesn't quite find it. The ultimate finds three members. The knockup follows up, and this is Xiaogu with the wombo combo. Can they clean it up? Doinbi gets knocked in by Shion.
Oh my god.
He completely ignores him. Cool goes down.
Oh my god.
North is being dived right now. He gets shredded down to zero health. Swift continues to chase. Three members of OMG dead. TNT doesn't quite find the reset, but oh, is he going to be able to get the tag? No, Loveling gets out alive. Dragon has just spawned, and Xiaogu get to breathe for
they
another few minutes.
They lose nothing. They need to pick up this dragon right now because you still need to deny the fifth dragon win condition for OMG. But we talked about this. Xiaogu, they lost all map control. They can't leave the base, but OMG can't enter the base.
Complete chaos this game as, again, the two teams butt heads and neither of them comes away with nothing but a bloody forehead.
I mean, Xiaogu are stronger right now. If they didn't have all of their inhibitors down and weren't fighting both OMG and minions, they could just end the game after repeated fights. So OMG, you know, they built up their lead, taking these towers, getting the map control, but they've just lost so much ground in the composition.
Yeah, dragon number two secured for Xiaogu. They deny that fifth dragon win condition for now. Middle inhibitor is respawned. The top inhibitor going to respawn within the next minute, and Xiaogu can breathe.
They just needed to be patient, apply the Baron buff across every single lane, flood the base with super creeps, and force Xiaogu to make a tougher decision. Of course Xiaogu were going to pull the trigger right then. They knew that they had run out of time because the super creep wave was going to hit their Nexus. And OMG, you know, despite having the two best disengages in the game, the Cask and the Monsoon, aren't able to get away from Swift.
Yeah, cool. Got absolutely destroyed that fight despite the Zhonya's Xiong trying to peel Doinbi and TNT away. Just wasn't able to do it in time. Top inhibitor has respawned, and now we're back to the same position we were in 6 minutes ago.
I mean, let's think about win condition for Xiaogu here.
Yeah.
I have a feeling they need to win probably two more team fights, and they can probably win the game. Whereas OMG just need to win, you know what, I'm going to say three. Three team fights for Xiaogu, one team fight for OMG. That's all they need, just one.
Will they be able to do it as they're taking on this second place team in the LPL right now?
I mean, I almost felt like at this point, because now it's a little bit dangerous because the death timers are getting so long,
yeah,
that at, you know, 45, 50 minutes, it's almost just one team fight because it's going to take a minute for you to respawn, and Xiaogu are just going to rush down the base again with Jinx, six items, towers are going to fall. Mm-hmm. But you almost just needed to pull the trigger and to possibly look for a 5v5. You know, can we 5v5 them? Because again, risk versus reward. If it was 35, 40 minutes, look for the 5v5, OMG get aced, the death timers aren't as punishing that they would be able to say, okay, that didn't work, but we didn't lose the game. Whereas now, they don't even get the option to attempt for that.
Yeah, we might be past that point now as we're approaching the 45-minute mark, and Xiaogu have been able to keep holding on, keep themselves in the game. Blue buff secured by North. I want to so bad.
45 minutes of Kog'Maw's passive just rocking my eardrums right now.
Exploding, yeah, it's absolutely fantastic. North is playing for OMG's playoff lives. This is an intense set as Xiaogu once again defending their base like they have been for the past 25 minutes.
Nope, and they're going to continue to do that until, because OMG, they know that they can't 5v5, so OMG are waiting for Dragon and they're waiting for Baron. And Xiaogu can't leave the base because if they get outmaneuvered by, you know, a crafty Twisted Fate teleport, I mean, if we're going to go full NALCS, high, some high shenanigans, some Splinter Cell.
Yeah.
So, I mean, Xiaogu, they have to just wait for OMG.
So let's take a step back. We're 46 minutes into the game now.
Oh, I stepped back.
How did we get here? Xiaogu got first blood onto Jinx, but OMG had complete control of the early game.
It was the big discrepancy between Xiong and V, especially on Swift. You know, Loveling recognizing that he could abuse Swift early because he was on that Sejuani. Putting them behind, and you know, Swift is the big playmaker for Xiaogu. It's a team full of playmakers, but especially on that Sejuani with that ultimate. And that was kind of the big catalyst here. So OMG, again, putting themselves in a position where in the early transition into mid-game, they understood that they had a lead, and they pushed it as far as possible by trying to snowball their advantage off of taking as many towers as quickly as possible. But unfortunately, just couldn't close it out fast enough to compensate for Xiaogu's composition, which this late in the game, six items on everyone, the massive AoE 5v5 is so much superior to OMG's pick comp. Pick Poke.
Pick Poke?
Pick Poke.
Let's see if they can pull it off. 40 seconds before Dragon's up, 2 minutes before Baron's up, 2 minutes before that Dragon. V actually just tried to teleport with the rest of Xiaogu and had to cancel it because he saw Kuul in that bottom lane.
That's a massive cooldown. Wasted. Again, we talked about how OMG are waiting for this Baron, which will spawn in 24 seconds. That said, if you need three Barons to win at 47 minutes in the game, I'm not quite sure that that's a victory.
Things not boding too well for OMG as they look to try closing this out. Kuul again split pushing in the bottom lane. V with no teleport. He knows what's going on. He's trying to pull some members of OMG. V is going to head over there. Going to be actually spotted out by a ward where the rest of OMG pull the trigger on that Baron. Swift, level 18 to the level 18 of Loveling. Here's
TNT. I believe in the Rocket.
Ooh, Zap finds Loveling.
I believe in the Rocket.
There's the Destiny Gate, and Rocket comes across, not able to pull it off.
I believed. Look at Kuul just booking away from V.
Yeah.
Okay, so they got the Baron. Attempt number two from OMG. This is what they want to do. Flood the base from every angle. Fight Xiaogu with creeps. Baroned up super creeps.
Xiaogu, however, aren't letting that happen. As five members, they've now grouped up in the mid lane.
They're going to have to back. Because they don't have teleport and they need to respond to the pressure on their bottom inhibitor. So right now what they're doing is, it's nice that they're applying pressure because OMG now have to delay their Baron timer because they need to respond to both the top wave and the mid wave. So that was Xiaogu saying, okay, we have this moment, this opportunity where they're on Baron and they don't want to fight us, so they're afraid of a flank. So we have the better position on the map. Force the mid wave in and at least delay their Baron siege window by, you know, 30, 45 seconds.
Yeah, very cerebral play out of these players. You can see Kuul farming right now. He's up to 493 minions.
That doesn't even matter at this point.
That is so huge. He's been getting 10 a minute for 49 minutes.
Did you know that Kuul has the highest GPM, I think, to ever be in a competitive League of Legends game? He got 610 gold. It's like a 610 GPM.
4?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not Dragon 5.
That's Dragon 4. Very solid pickup by OMG. Not only do they have one of the highest gold earning mid laners, but now they've got that Dragon 4 for themselves. Split push pressure activated. Three members bottom, one member mid, one member top.
They learned their lesson. They're applying in every single lane.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah.
Can they get away with this?
How many more times will they get this opportunity?
They're not going to get this opportunity. I think if they die here, depending on how many members are left, it'll be the game either way. That's going to be my bold prediction.
North gets tagged by the Winner's Bite, but nobody from Xiaogu can follow up. Kuul roaming around to join up with the rest of the team. They swap, sending Xi on top. V's teleport is back up, and now the inhibitors starting to take some poke. North, whoa, he does damage.
Okay, just siege it up. Careful, that's a big cooldown.
Glacial Fissure completely whiffed, as it looks like TCG's letting a bit of the pressure get to him.
It's because Swift was posturing from the side. They were looking for the engage right there, but Swift decided not to pull the trigger, so OMG doing a much better job recognizing where the engage angles are from Xiaogu.
Oh, Swift catches up. He looks for Loveling. Doesn't quite find him as they try to clear the way of Kuul. Trying to split on the far side. Xiang doesn't even care that V is there. He's trying to poke down the turret.
They just need to dance. They just need to disengage. You have the tools. Cask and Monsoon.
Continue to wait. Can Xiaogu pull the trigger? They've got that Glacial Arctic Prison ready. Arctic Assault.
Arctic Prison?
Yes.
Glacial Prison.
That's the one.
Arctic Assault.
I'm so excited for this game, I don't even know how to word. Yeah, Xiang without Meganar finally gets an opportunity to get some pressure back onto the inhibitor turrets. Baron just wearing off.
How crazy of a comeback would this be?
This would be amazing. Slowly but surely,
oh,
the
got
Arctic
it.
Assault lands. Xiang jumps over the wall. Glacial Prison. But they don't follow up. Xiaogu can't take the kills.
They can't lock them down. Again, OMG, they learned their lesson. Baron buff has fallen off. And they only got a single inhibitor.
This is so close. Xiaogu are barely hanging on, but they are still in this game. One inhibitor down. Super minions pushing the bottom lane while Kuul looks to break the top one. V keeping him occupied.
I mean, OMG, what's your plan here? You're going to wait another 7 minutes for Baron?
Yeah, maybe another 70 more. Like,
I'll be ready to cast.
Yeah, 12 Barons.
Man.
One game.
Imagine if every game is like this. It's not like we have a 9-hour day tomorrow where you and I cast every single game.
Yeah. It's going to be great.
How about those OPL finals?
So, Swift holding on. One inhibitor is down. Rocket, ooh, tag's cool. Stops his recall. Just a bit of a nuisance from TNT.
Okay.
I don't even think at this point gold matters.
Fifth right dragon. Now. Fifth dragon will come before the next Baron. And Xiaogu have to fight for it. We'll see if OMG set up for a 5v5 there, or if they're going to, again, attempt to play with pressure by maybe sending Cool or Xiang to apply pressure on the bottom side. It's unfortunate because it's the bottom inhib, and the next big area that they want to fight in is the Dragon Pit versus the Baron Pit. So they can't play with split or cross map pressure. But I think that this is best case scenario for OMG, is that they try to lure Xiaogu into the Dragon Pit, get them to leave the base, and then send either Xiang or Cool to take everything behind them. But if they get ace there, then it's a base race.
Yeah. Then it gets a little chaotic. Cool actually split pushing with the super minions. He's going to drop a forward ward, but Swift already in position to catch that wave while V continues to man the fort in the top lane. He's going to see Cool now. I like how North is still exploding. It's like a bell on a
you
dog.
You like that?
Yeah, it's like a bell on a dog. You don't see him on your screen, but you hear it in your periphery. You're just like, oh, North is here. But 53 and a half minutes in, Xiaogu still holding on.
I want a timer. I want people to go back to this VOD and just find like a timer. Xiaogu are still holding on. OMG still attempting, like just ding, 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 ding.
Exciting,
thrilling, incredible, beautiful.
It's slowed down.
Absolutely beautiful.
Careful now, Atlas.
Weird.
So this game has dropped a little bit. Certainly less exciting than it was 10 minutes ago.
No, it's still, it's just funny. Because they both know. But Xiaogu just can't do anything about it. Like, that's what's hilarious to me. Mm-hmm. And OMG, like, you know that that guy's stronger. You know that they can kill you. But it's just about, like, haha, can't touch me, can't touch me.
Outsmarting the school bully.
I'm not hitting you. I'm not hitting you. That's what it reminds me of.
OMG continuing to just maneuver around the map.
They're waiting for Dragon.
Keeping forward pressure up. They are indeed. Baron's up at 30. Dragon number 5 in 40.
Xiaogu. I thought you said Baron number 5 for a second. I was like, has it really been? No, but it's been, what, coming on?
3.
4 Barons?
So this would be the 4th.
Oh my.
So that Dragon's in 30 seconds. Baron in 15. Large neutral objectives.
This
OMG
is the longest game of LPL.
Already? 55
yeah
minutes?
I believe so.
Go for some records.
I don't want to.
I think 100 minutes, we can make it.
I don't want to.
We're halfway there.
I don't want to.
Okay, Xiaogu actually heading for the Baron right now on the top side. Are they going to trade over? Dragon number 5 spawns.
That's not a fair trade. Although
they're
it might be.
Starting the Baron right now, and OMG are actually rushing forward. They're going to try contesting this. Loveling's there.
Teleport
coming in from V. The inhibitor has respawned. He's deep in enemy lines. Nice and tanky at this point. Xiang looking for the stun.
You got it.
It's secured. Xiaogu managed to take it. V getting low. TNT's in the back of the pit trying to turn it around. V still alive. They find North, but the cleanse keeps him alive. A stun finds Xiaogu. He trades it around. Unbreakable, keeping TNT alive. They're trying
watch
to turn
TNT
this around. Xiaogu are looking for it. Oh, the monsoon disengages. Xiaogu still not finding any kills. Oh my gosh, they're guiding forward. Doinby forced to flash away.
Just get out.
Yeah, they might have overstayed their welcome. TNT is caught. They're looking for the dive. Destiny Gate's not enough. They managed to pick up the kill on the North, who overextends. Cool. Getting tagged now. A double kill for TNT. Now it's going to be turned around, and Xiaogu, they're going to take out 3 members and win the team fight.
They just lost the game.
Baron. 70 seconds. Can Xiaogu end this? They're running down the mid lane right now. No, the minions are getting onto the base.
Okay, they just need to send one back because they have the Baron buff. You have massive death timers on top of Xiang, Cool, and North.
Oh my god. They're on the base.
One person go back.
They're trying to end. Nobody's going back. They're trying to push forward now. One inhibitor turret goes down. That Nexus turret is being sheathed. You can see them pinging. You can see them rushing for it. The Nexus is going down, but the minion wave spawns. Oh, they've got the minion wave to keep them alive for a few seconds. Nexus turret number 1 goes low. Loveling dashes in. He actually gets a kill, but they're trying to turn it around. TNT on the next one. Swift forced to jump away from turret aggro. This is the next Nexus turret going down. The minions aren't going to be able to do it in time. TNT's low. V about to drop. Xiaogu take the win and end up 2-0.
over OMG.
A 57-minute game. Xiaogu finished their LPL season strong with the 2-0. They had 3 points available to them this weekend, and they pick up all three.
Yeah, amazing play. Oh, man. You can see some members in the audience crying after that set.
Okay, let's talk about the decision making. So I said that's not worth the trade. I retract that statement. So the reason why Xiaogu are going to look for the Baron versus the fifth dragon or denial of the fifth dragon is because the Baron would actually mean more for them. Their 5v5 comp is already stronger than OMG, that if they did get the fifth dragon, that's still a 50-50 coin toss at this point. So by having the Baron, it denies the siege and the pressure game that OMG are trying to make. So yeah, I support that call. Go for the Baron, ignore the fifth dragon, bait OMG into a 5v5. Cool. So misplayed that fight. Completely on the wrong side. I think he maybe threw 3 gold cards over the entirety of maybe like a 45-second long fight.
Yeah, things not quite working out for Xiaogu. You can see Xiong looking a little bit sad right now. It's a 2-0 going over to Xiaogu. They're going to end this split of the LPL with the longest game yet. At 35 points in the standings in second place. So far, there are only 2 teams that can pass them now. It's Invictus Gaming and, OMG can't pass them anymore. I believe the only team that can pass them is...
Invictus. Again, it is so crucial for Xiaogu to place as high as possible. They need to perform well into this playoff if they want to get enough circuit points to get an invitation for the world's qualifiers.
Yeah. All about worlds right now for Xiaogu, and they're showing that even with the 50-minute game, 2 inhibitors down.
You know, we talked about Sivir.
Yeah.
How Sivir is a big pickup for TNT.
It's his
most played champion. They find a lot of success on that. It's interesting. When you look at a best of 5 and a best of 3, the pick band draft mentality changes for teams because you have to assume if it's a best of 5 or that final game, both teams are going to look for late game scaling comps because you're not going to risk your last game of a set on like a level 1 play or an early snowball. So a lot of times you'll see teams go for, you know, Vayne, Kog'Maw, Jinx, Tristana, things like that. So, you know, the fact that they took Jinx, and this wasn't a best of 5, but, you know, making sure the last game of their LPL split, not taking the utility, taking the hyperscale, especially because they see the Kog'Maw across.
Yeah.
It's the same sort of mentality that you would see in a best of 5 or an elongated series. We're going to play this one safe and slow. Even with the Sejuani pickup, we know it's going to go late game, and we know we can beat you there.
Yeah, so Xiaogu coming in from the LSPL. This is their first split in the LPL. They end at 35 points, currently making a strong play for that second place spot, beating OMG in a 2-0 in an amazing set. I mean, Xiaogu, these guys, it's amazing. Where did they come from?
The 3 top team fighting teams in the LPL, it is going to be EDG, Xiaogu, and Snake. Hmm. If there's anyone you do not want to face at 50 minutes in the game, they just proved it.
Most certainly. Well, that's going to be a quick break from us. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back with the next game.